Je m'appelle Dean.
Oh, wow.
I play Killy.
I'm Aidan Turner.
He didn't even hear that. I said Killy.
Oh, did you?
Yeah.
Oh,
I did it on purpose.
He didn't even know.
Didn't even. You're Killy and I'm Philly.
Yeah, well, even Peter can't tell the difference these days. Yeah, I play Killy. Yeah, I think.
Well, it's a long, complicated process. You have to grow your facial hair. You have to eat and drink a lot. You have to be kind of good at fighting.
Yeah.
And you have to fight a lot.
You got to be pretty decent with a sword, all right?
Yeah. You got to be sweaty, I think. Mm-hmm. Being sweaty is kind of a requirement.
Sweaty. Yeah, and you got to learn how to be small as well. It's a difficult skill to learn, but we achieved that, I think, in 2 years.
Yeah.
No, it's that work is done for you, really. Yeah. I mean, you know, the odd time you might have to look at a tennis ball, you know, for Gandalf or whatever, but it's kind of, it's down to the technical, the camera team really, and Peter to make all that happen, you know.
I think there was a challenge though, because it is a very technical movie in a lot of ways, the 3D cameras and stuff, so it did take a bit of getting used to having to, you know, change your eye lines a lot, work on a green screen.
Yeah, but that slave motion control thing, that's simultaneously working two cameras and all that kind of
thing. You know, hitting specific marks was much more important on this film because the cameras is just much more technical. I don't really know what I'm talking about, but it was
we never did though. We don't know anything about this. We pretend we do. We're showing the cracks in them.
The cameras. Camera's so tricky to
CGI,
use.
Amazing. I love it so much. Yeah. I mean, we were just saying it earlier. I mean, for the first time ever, for me anyway, it was, I could just completely immerse myself in this film and not keep breaking out and going, oh my God, this is my bit coming up, or this, that's my mate, you know, I know him. Like in the first movie, you're waiting for all these moments to happen, or you see a bit of a bit of Goblin Town, and you start thinking what it was like to shoot it and stuff. And last night, it wasn't that at all. I just saw it for the movie it was, and the momentum and the pace of the movie just carried me through it. It was brilliant.
Which is great, because you get to actually sort of see it how an audience member would
exactly,
see it.
Yeah.
And so, you know, when we get to answer questions, we can sort of think about it from the audience perspective much better, because we got, caught up on the ride. Mm. He likes making just little independent films, eh?
Small, subtle
films.
Guerrilla
limited
films,
release.
Yeah.
He's an incredible guy, and I think that it's almost easy to take for granted, because you see so much of his stuff and you work on it for, you know, 2.5 years, but he's created this entire world, you know, and he's made sure it's all just how it needs to be.
But he's a great collaborator as well, after creating all of this and bringing all these people together, and he's a great delegator too. I mean, he gets the best people in the business together to make it all work for him, but he gives a lot certainly to the performers, you know. We get a lot of freedom to do what we want to do, and then the last take, he'll tell you what he wants, and that's the one he'll use in the film.
Yeah.
But up until that point, you feel like you have a lot of freedom.
And he has this like fountain of energy that just is inside him, because he just hardly ever sleeps, you know.
No,
at the wrap party for the end of the films, I asked him, you know, how was it, and he hadn't slept for 2 days.
Yeah,
he just pushed through. I mean, he's kind of
amazing.
He's sort of incredible.
Amazing,
yeah.
A bit of both, really. I mean, you know, there's not an awful lot in the book that sort of character stuff for Feely and Killy necessarily.
Yeah.
So a lot of it was collaborating with Peter and Fran and Philippa on the characters and stuff like that. So, and a lot of it, you just kind of, as you go along and as you relate to other characters in the film, you begin to sort of explore your character more, and stuff just happens on set, and you kind of go, oh God, that's the kind of person he is.
We had almost 2 years to really work on our
character. A long time to do that, you know.
And a lot of it was shot sequentially, really.
That's right,
I mean, the film was
in
a way shot from beginning to end, which is unusual. Man, there's so many. Maybe specifically the second one explores the idea of greed, you know, because there's the dragon, and he hoards all the gold, but he doesn't actually use it. He just wants it for himself.
How wealth and power can corrupt, I guess, and then, you know, how much it actually means to the person that's, to the wealthy people. Work that out. What does that mean?
Yeah, that was really good.
Nice, mate.
That was deep.
That's a poignant thought there.
Typically poignant.